I find it almost impossible to think this is my sister.
Bernice is an amazing 6'4" transsexual.
Very much after the operation, she was just so happy. It's all over, I've done it, I'm a woman.
I am Bernice Roust. I'm a student at Westminster University. Short of other things to say about me. I'm transgendered. I had my operation in just before the turn of the millennium, which made me very happy. I live in Brentford, down by the River Thames, and I'm 46 years old.
Certainly when we were young children and we were together, I couldn't, you know, I wouldn't have known what was, you know, wrong at all. All I knew was that Bernie was had great difficulties relating to other people at school. My parents found some jewellery and stuff that Bernie had to use, I guess, with this cross-dressing. And I overheard them sort of confronting him about it, but I don't think anything ever came of it. It was sort of all hidden under the table.
Eventually, when I moved to secondary school, they sent me to a special school for emotionally disturbed and maladjusted boys. Well, start with telling me I'm a boy, it must have made me a bit emotionally disturbed and maladjusted.
They used to call him a sissy and all that sort of thing, but I can't remember the exact details, but it was quite severe name-calling. Obviously, you know, this was what was the problem all the time, but none of us knew that. It was, you know, so obviously from a very early age, Bernie knew that.
And I suppose I was about 19 when I really thought, God here, I'm sitting at home in a nice frock and I'm really enjoying it. Perhaps I'm not the straight, red-blooded heterosexual that everybody expects me to be.
He was always different. I didn't really realise in what way he was different for many, many years.
Had a couple of girlfriends, I suppose, when I was 14 and 16, and both of them had just done my head in and not made me very happy at all.
When I first knew her, was definitely living and working as a man, very tall, incredibly handsome, beautiful, beautiful sculpted face, long hair. Possibly the only giveaway was that whereas most men, when they were working and doing soldering and such thing, would just tie their hair back with a tie, Bernice used to have the most amazing collection of tortoiseshell hair slides. So that was ever such a slight edge that I thought, a bit strange.
What I did is I said, to hell with it, I'm a man. Got myself a really good job for the European Space Agency in Holland. Moved there, got as confused as can be. Had another girlfriend. It didn't work. But I, you know, ultimately I just got well confused. It resulted in my losing the job there, coming back to England, living in the back of the car for a couple of months, and when I came home for Christmas, my dad called the doctor and I found myself in a mental hospital.
He came back from Holland in a very bad state mentally. I think he'd probably known for some, or she'd probably known for some time what had to be done, but it was from then on that Bernice started to surface, I guess.
I am a woman inside, and there was no way of avoiding it.
Girls can wear jeans and cut their hair short, wear shirts and boots. Is it okay to be a boy? But for a boy to look like a girl is degrading. Because you think that being a girl is degrading. But secretly, you'd love to know what it's like, wouldn't you?
And I'd start off down here, and I'd get my flagon of cider, big spliff, acid in the cider, and start swigging. And by the time I got to the top, I don't think I ever remembered getting to the top, because I'd be so out of it. When I was there as a young man, it was very much a lad's thing, go out, do something completely illegal, do lots of drugs, have a fun time. But that was only the very most outside. As soon as I got there, I learnt different things about myself and about people.
Bernice told me that one time when she was living in Hounslow, that she was getting a lot of hassle from the local kids.
She started appearing as a woman. At that time, I didn't know that this was going to lead eventually to gender reassignment.
I decided I would live as a woman. It was my 35th birthday. I had, for a little while before then, occasionally turned up to work in a skirt, and I'd never made a big secret of the fact that I would cross-dress occasionally. First of all, people are shocked. Then you get the few that produce open hostility. Others, I was surprised how many others did rally round and support me.
I'm also very proud of Robin for what he did.
Because I didn't do anything.
Yes, you did. Because I had made this promise to Bernice well before Robin and I got married. And I always said to her, look, when it comes to the op, I know your family aren't being very helpful to you, and you are going to need help afterwards. You can't just go back to a flat and be on your own. You're going to need somebody to look after you. And if nobody else will do it, you come and stay with me. In the meantime, we got married. And I said to Rob, look, I've made a promise and I can't renege on it. You can always go and stay with your brother if you don't want to be around. But, I mean, Robin was fantastic and helped me look after Bernice.
It doesn't bother me.
Not that she took much looking after. It was mainly cooking.
I began to live as a woman, by which time, of course, I'd be having counselling from the gender identity clinic. I have to see a psychiatrist. I think they quite deliberately make it a very slow process so that anybody who is not determined doesn't get there. I don't think anybody goes for any surgery unless it's absolutely necessary. It's always a frightening prospect. But I must say, nothing in my life has ever made me happier.
An identity that's difficult to inhabit, and you have to change that, and to change it so radically, is a very courageous act, and I've got a huge degree of respect for that.
I've been sitting looking at people as a woman, thinking, if I was still a bloke, I would be getting really embarrassed right now. I would be having to hide my tent pole and I wouldn't be able to stand up. Whereas now I can look at this guy and I can move.
Very much after the operation, she was just so happy. And it's over. I've done it. It's all done. And I am now a woman. I've got everything that I wanted.
Bernice is Bernice. It's like knowing a woman who you don't particularly fancy, but who you're big mates with.
Speaking for myself, no, I wouldn't fancy Bernice.
I mean, from the other aspect...
But there again, some people might.
What annoys me is it's never someone I really fancy. No.
I don't feel that Bernice is any longer my brother. I don't feel that there's anything that I've lost in the relationship. I think, to an extent, I've only gained from the fact that Bernie is very much happier.
How can I compare her man and woman? Still essentially the same person. Kind, ever helpful, incredibly useful, especially when you're short like me. As a man, strong, very capable. If I was stuck, would always turn a hand to mending my car. As a woman...
Mend your car.
Would still probably mend my car for me, but would probably wonder about sort of breaking a fingernail.
Tell someone to love me, I need to rest in arms.
Now, other things are more important. Oh, I know that there's a future to my life. Where it takes me, I don't know, neither does anyone else. But I know there is one, and I know there's many more interesting things to do.
As my soul heals the shame, I will grow through this pain. Lord, I'm doing all I can to be a better man. Go easy on my conscience, 'cause it's not my fault. I know I've been taught to take the blame.